everyone, Happy Skipper here. I'm coming to you with another tank review. This time we're going to do the E25. It's a tier 7 premium tank. Previously on console, this tank was not available unless you bought it in the early release bundle, which I did. And actually, it just came out available on the tank tech tree, so I think you can get it now individually for 6,700 gold is what I was told it goes for. And I'm going to give you a little review on what the tank is like, so you can decide whether or not you want to purchase it. I'm going to start off by saying, if you know anything about the E25 from PC, it was removed from PC, and that should tell you something, much like the Waffle, that they obviously had balancing issues with it on the good side. Basically, the tank was too good, and they didn't want to change it, or they tried, and they didn't know how to do it properly without making customers upset for purchasing it and then changing it, so they got rid of it altogether. Now we have it on console, and after driving it now for almost 200 battles, I can tell you that yes, it's broken. It's an unbalanced tank. It's very overpowered. But with that being said, it's not for everyone, and I've seen plenty of drivers do badly in this tank, so it doesn't do it for you. But if you're a good player, if you're an intermediate to advanced player, you're going to have a lot of fun and really do well in this tank. But in order to do that, you have to understand some concepts of the game that beginners don't understand. And I'm going to talk about those things real quick. I'm going to go over the advantages and disadvantages of the tank. And after we do that, I can show you my equipment loadout, my consumables, and my crew skills. And they'll make more sense when we talk about what the tank does well and what balancing features it has to hold it back. So starting off, number one, we're going to go with the advantages. If you look to the right, you can see concealment value is 74. That is one of the highest concealment values in the entire game. I believe that the AMX ELC is better, and the Hidden, a Tier 5 tank destroyer, like a Stoke variation that's just recently come out, is a little bit higher. But other than that, this is one of the best camo values you'll see in the entire game. As you can see, it's very low profile, which is why the concealment value is so high. But an after effect of this concealment value is going to be your ability to stay hidden and fire on targets who are unsuspecting. Let's take a look at the gun real quick. Now, I've talked about camo value. The gun fires 20 rounds a minute. 150 millimeters of penetration. We're going to talk about that in the disadvantage section. But at 135 damage, this gun kicks out incredible DPM. Aim time is 1.5. That is unheard of, basically, in tank destroyers. And the accuracy is 0.3, which is definitely good. So, in every respect, the gun is amazing rate of fire. Great accuracy and aim time. One of the limiting factors with the gun is a disadvantage and a balancing feature. Two balancing features that are put on the gun is basically the penetration for standard round is 150. That's a little bit low, especially when you're talking about the fact that this tank does see tier 8 tanks. It's a preferential matchmaking tank, which is actually one of its strengths. It doesn't see tier 9 tanks. It would not do well against tier 9 tanks. Because even the APCR, which fires at 194 millimeters of penetration, that's not going to do anything to tier 9 tanks. So 150 millimeters of penetration with the standard round is clearly a balancing feature. It's not unheard of for premium tanks to have to fire APCR, but this is definitely a tank where you're going to fire a good amount of APCR, especially when you're talking about tier 8 opponents. There's no way that 150 millimeter penetration on AP rounds is going to penetrate an IS-6 unless you're maybe standing right behind him, shooting him in the backside. That's about the only chance you have. So you're definitely going to want to load some APCR. It is a balancing feature of the tank, and you're just going to have to get used to it. I can't see people getting really upset about an E25 shooting them with APCR, just because it is a well-known balancing feature of the tank. Another balancing feature with the gun is going to come from the consumable section. Here, I'm going to take a look. There's only 60 shells on the tank, and that is not an accident. That is done on purpose. It is a limited amount of shells. I know 60 sounds like a lot of shells, but if you look at the rate of fire and you look at the amount of damage it does per hit, you're going to be expecting to do, you know, somewhere in the neighborhood of 20 to 30 penetrations on a really good game. You're going to have some misses. You're going to have some bounces. So if you're having a great game, those shells, that shell count is, I'm telling you, is going to come into play, and I'm going to have videos and gameplay to show you where that comes into play and how significant it is. So you're gonna have to learn. It took me some experience to learn it, but you're gonna have to learn with this tank that you don't want to be firing shots out willy-nilly. You want to make them count, which is another reason why you want to probably load some more APCR than usual, because of the fact that you really want to make your shots count. You only get so many shells, and when you shoot as much as this tank fires, your shell count is very important, and 60 is low. You can see right here I have a mixture of 35 to 25 APCR. You could definitely go 50-50, no problem. But I definitely recommend you carry a good amount of APCR in this tank. You're gonna need it. There's just a lot of customers that you can't pen with AP rounds. You definitely want to carry some AP, no doubt, because there are some softer targets up there, especially if you're running into tier 6 or tier 5 tanks. You're gonna not want to waste the money and just the bad look of firing APCR at light tanks or lower tier tanks. I've learned as I played the tank more and more and more that the AP rounds are usable. You just have to know the situations. I would not use any HE at all. You just don't have enough shells. I mean, 60 shells, I'm telling you, is low. And the penetration on this HE is so bad that you couldn't even rely on it if you wanted to. I just don't trust it, and when you're in a low shell count, I don't have time for HE. Alright? So that's the gun advantages and disadvantages. We talked about the camo value. I want to talk about the maneuverability real quick, and that is a huge thing that people don't really realize with this tank. You have to prioritize the concealment and the camo value and firing on targets without being detected. That is the number one strength of the tank. But when push comes to shove and you have to get in there, this tank moves like a light tank. It's as fast. It's maybe faster than most of the light tanks you'll have on your team. It's fast, and it's got a very low profile, and it's extremely shifty. The traverse speed is unbelievable. The power to weight ratio, you have a 44 traverse, and the power to weight ratio is over 26. This thing flies around the map. As a matter of fact, I was in a game last night where I saw an E25 on Dragon Ridge drive basically through our entire team, and no one could land a hit on him. He was moving full speed, he was doing serpentine motion, and he's such a low profile, he's so hard to hit. The only way to really hit these E25s is if they're not moving. If they're moving, it's a really hard shot. So your maneuverability, your low profile, your speed, that is an offensive weapon, but it's also a defensive weapon, because I'll tell you right now, this tank doesn't have any armor at all. So if you get hit, it's penning. I mean, there's just nothing there, guys. There's no armor to speak of. So what you need to do for your defensive tactics is to keep moving, and use serpentine motion and try and get your speed up, which isn't hard to do with this thing. But as far as the other, what else? It has, not only does it have no armor, it has a relatively low HP pool, so you're not going to be able to do a lot of shot trading. Those are the disadvantages of the tank. You're no armor, low HP pool, and your gun has pen issues, and you have a relatively low shell count. Those are the disadvantages. The advantages are high camo value, great speed and maneuverability, and an amazing gun with incredible DPM. All right, so now we'll be going over the advantages and disadvantages. We're going to look at the equipment real quick. This is kind of easy to figure out if you ask me. Rammer, camouflage net to enhance your camo value, and binoculars to enhance your view range. The tank doesn't have the greatest view range. What do we have? 360 for a tank destroyer. That's a little bit low, I guess you could say, but that's why binoculars help out so much. When we talk about the crew skills, if you can see here on the right, I have both the situational awareness and recon, along with camo value or camo skill and muffled shot. I would definitely, after you get sixth sense is number one, of course, in this tank, you need to know if you're spotted. Mentor and brothers in arms, I would do camo skill, then I would do muffled shot, because firing undetected is the most important thing in this tank. Then I would work on your vision skills, and some of the other crew skills are a little bit more toward clutch braking and off-road driving, or because I'm also running the German line of the Waffle TVs, so that is not for this tank. But like I said, I would prioritize your camouflage, muffled shot, and then your view range skills. Dead eye is also really great, just because you're going to hit targets multiple times with this rate of fire. So Deadeye is nice to have. Those are the crew skills. I told you about consumables a little bit as far as my ammo loadout. Also, I have been running chocolate for a while. I think I'm running it right now just because the crew that I put in here wasn't fully trained. But I've recently taken it off. As far as I use small repair kits, small first aid kit. Could you run this premium consumable? Certainly. You don't have a lot of HP, so, I mean, if you get caught on fire, you're probably going to die regardless if you have a fire extinguisher or not. So, I've already free-marked the tank. I normally don't run it with premium consumable anymore, just to make a little bit of money. But I would understand if you just got the thing, if you want to try it out that way. There's a possibility of other equipment loadouts. I haven't gone there yet. I don't see any reason to change what I have, just because it's been working beautifully. As I said, I've already three-marked the tank and had a lot of success in it, almost a 4,400 win 8. So, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. And that's where I'm at with the tank right now. I'm going to show you some gameplay. Last thing I want to talk about, actually, before the gameplay is when push comes to shove, this tank has an amazing up-close and personal encounter ability. That's one of the things that people don't know about the tank is, other than the camo value and shooting undetected, if you have to get into a close quarters engagement, this tank is so maneuverable that it can get up to the side, and it has incredible DPM, and there's a lot of tanks in the game that just don't have the HP pool, especially if you're waiting till later in the game, you're full health and they're not. Even if you have to eat one shot from them, you're going to be able to drain their HP pool before they can kill you. And yeah, you're going to see in some of my gameplay the close encounter abilities of this tank, and it's pretty vicious up close and personal. So it's a well-rounded tank in that it can hit you from afar, but if you really push it, it can really tear tanks up close and personal. It's pretty amazing how well it does that. So, all right, I'm going to show you some gameplay. You're going to get examples of all that stuff. Thanks for watching. All right, we're at our first gameplay clip. I like both these gameplay clips because I think they show you both aspects of the tank. Most of these maps will start off with me using the camo value in a place that, you know, and going to a place undetected that I probably shouldn't be able to go to. Not only am I going to be doing some high-level spotting, but I'm also going to be able to hit opponents from places that I shouldn't be able to shoot from undetected most of the time. And then they both end with some aggressive close encounters play, so it shows you both aspects of this tank. Here we are on highway. I'm going to use all my experience running light tanks and spotting to go to, it's kind of a tricky little area from this spawn. I love spawning on this side, though, because there's a network of bushes over here on the E-line, and they have different layers to them, but if you utilize them correctly, you can light up their entire team coming down the A-B line. Here's probably the outside layer of bushes. This is probably the first layer right here. I would say this is the fourth layer, if you will. Notice I'm not detected by a light tank streaking by, and here's an ELC. My camo net is up, which helps, but it wasn't up for the Chaffee. It is up now. I'm in the first network of bushes. I don't really want to proceed, because those two light tanks will light me, and I don't want to be lit at the start of the game. Plus, this network of bushes going down the E-line, you know, E2, E3, E4, they're great, but if you get lit here, it gets really dicey, because there's usually a lot of tank destroyers sitting on the hill at, like, C7 or B7 looking for a target right now. They're just hungry for a target, and I don't want to be it. I'm going to move up to the next layer of bushes here. I knocked some trees down several times in this game. Trees can provide an extra bush layer of camouflage, if you will. Anyone who believes in that myth about, like, you knock down trees and you're giving away your position to artillery, I'm not saying it's not true, I'm just saying I'm not concerned about it. It is yet to really ever be a problem for me. Alright, so as you can see now, I'm in the bush. When my binoculars go on, I'm basically lighting all their tanks. I have 5 detects already, so I am definitely doing the job as a light tank right now. Or, for our light tank right now. There's a light tank next to me, but he's not... I'm obviously outspotting him. That's 6 detects now. Here's their light tank coming through. Notice, I'm in a bush with my camo net up, and I'm firing at light tanks, and I'm not being lit. Here's a jumbo, got to fire some APCR here. I've been firing APCR here to start the match, pretty much. I haven't really seen the light tank. I guess I could have switched for, but I knew I was gonna have a very short window of time to hit him. So I wasn't gonna switch ammo just because I only expected to get one, maybe two shots into him. Alright, so, like, here I'm at, like, the third layer of bushes. There's bushes more to my right, but, again, you gotta be kind of cautious, because I don't want to get lit. So, here I kind of make my own little spot. There's really not, there's a set of bushes right to there to the right, but I'm not gonna go all the way in there. I just knock this tree down, kind of making it into a makeshift bush. I have this barrel of hay next to me on the left. I'm concerned that the tanks are up to my left, but, I'm more interested in getting these guys lit and taken care of. It's their support tanks that I'm worried about. There's four heavy tanks on the one line right now that are dealing with the Japanese heavy and whatever else is up there. There's two heavy tanks up there. You know, it's 4-on-2. I think they can take it. Plus, it's not really my up front, and, you know, brawling with Japanese heavies is not my, not really my job here. So, I'm making some more bushes for myself. I probably should have just moved up to the bushes on my right here and gone to that second layer. But, I'm just trying to play a view range game with the Black Prince. It's not going to be working in his favor. I have a lot more view range than him and definitely have camouflage factor over him. So I'm just kind of moving from bush to bush, very systematically, moving in one more layer at a time. Every time my binoculars come on, I usually am spotting something. I'm keeping my eye on the heavy tanks up there. I don't want to be lit by them, but I'm really not interested in going after them unless they completely crush all my teammates up there, which would be disappointing. I want to point out right there that I got lit the moment I fired at the Black Prince, and it prompted me to go on the forums and to start doing some research. If my camo net had been up there, I think I would have been able to fire undetected. I know, you know, we always say, well, when you fire, you lose all the camo value from the bushes around you, and your tank's camo value goes down significantly. Yes, it is reduced. With that being said, the camo net value is still there. It still adds to my overall camo. So is there a reduction factor? Yes. Is it nullified completely? I do not believe that to be the case. So if you can wait for your camo net to engage sometimes, if it's an extra second, I would do it, because I found, especially with the E25, more often than not, having that camo net engage and then firing has kept me undetected more times than not. It depends on the distance and the view range of your opponent, of course. But here we're talking about a Black Prince who doesn't have very good view range. And with my camo value, I should easily win this this view range contest. So the fact that he saw me there, I think the camo net would have been enough of a factor to put that in my favor. I really thought this tank was going to move forward. Apparently he didn't. He just kind of angled differently. It's not going to matter. I run out of APCR here after I track him. You'll see that this shot right here is an AP shell that pens just fine. I think it was a little bit earlier in my E25 career during this game, and I definitely started to utilize more AP as I got better at the tank. So, you know, there's an argument there for using AP more than not. Especially in a Tier 7 game, don't be afraid to fire AP and save yourself some silver. Alright, here, I like this part of the game just because there's no way that I'm going to be able to get more damage and play some kind of camo game anymore. We're down to artillery and this T-34-85. This is where you get to see what this tank can do up close and personal. I'm not even going to try and hide from them. I'm just going to run up and just use my DPM on him. I'm full health, which is a product of doing, you know, being conservative and being smart with this tank during the game. Now, because of my status of being full health and him no longer being full health, I'm just going to DPM him. I'll eat the shots from him. It doesn't matter. I actually missed one. Doesn't matter. He still couldn't one-shot me if he wanted to. Here, I go up on the hill just to get an angle down on the artillery. I'm just racing my teammates here for this damage. That's all this is. Artillery mix, I don't know what that is. Is that what happens if you snapshot an artillery? Just went into the ground. So, a really good game. Again, really showing off the view range capabilities with binoculars, showing off the incredible camo value. And at the end, you got a little bit of a taste for what this tank can do up close and personal. I have a lot of videos. I'm not going to show you them all, but some games stress the up close and personal close encounters abilities more than others. That was just a taste, as I said. Going into this game, once again, I'm going to start the map off by basically showing you the incredible camo value. I go to a place on this map from this spawn that I never go to with any tanks. But with the E25, I experimented, and this bush, which I never even noticed before, honestly, is actually enough of a little bit of extra camo to allow me to sit and fire from a position that I don't think a tank should be able to go to and fire undetected. We do have a light tank who goes in front and spots, and that's very helpful. I don't think with my view range, even with my binoculars up, I would have been able to detect all the tanks that are going to be lit. But as you can see from my location, I'm able to completely decimate their team as that's crossing to the 1-2 line. So this guy, I'm trying to get by this medium here. Light tank's going ahead. Now, while he's in that riverbed down there, he's not spotting anything, so tanks could potentially be getting by. This bush I didn't even know was here. And now I'm in a bush with my camo net and my binoculars. He just spotted the M6, and I'm basically gonna just shred this tank. Yeah, I lit him on fire. He gets away, but he's half health. Here's an ELC. Now, that's an ELC, it's a light tank. I am firing at him, I'm undetected, and I'm outspotting him. Some of this stuff is kind of hard to lead. Look at this T67. Look at the lead I had to give him with APCR. But I hit him in the engine, he's dead. That was a lot of lead. From this distance, you gotta have a lot of lead. You can tell the shots that I'm missing, I'm not leading enough. Alright, here we have a Black Prince. Kind of a damaged pinata. I probably should have been shooting him more on the side of his turret since his turret is turned than trying to hit that one thin plate in his upper front plate. He does have a flat front plate underneath his turret. You want to aim for that, or you want to, if you're going to fire APCR, you want him in his cheeks maybe. Alright, that's becoming too hard of a target for me to hit. I'm going to try and put a couple shells into this hammer, who's basically like hull down, even though hull down in a hammer doesn't really mean anything. So now he's trying to move. I might get a couple, maybe get one more shot in him. No, before he leaves. Alright, this place is used up. I have already 14 pens. I have 4 detects. So I was doing some spotting for my team, especially when the light tank left. So I don't know, maybe with maxed out view skills, binos engaged, you could light all their tanks that go by there. There's not much for us on Ice Road. I see that they have 3 heavy tanks there. That's the bulk of their team. So I'm going to try and see if I get some side shots on their heavy tanks since this is definitely the flank that they're winning. They're certainly not going to be winning the 1-2 after we just completely beat up their team. Alright, now I get lit by the IS-2. Doesn't even know he lit me at this point. Now he's crossing. Now he realizes he lit me. IS-2 would really hurt. I'm not really willing to eat that shot. Plus, he's not giving me much to shoot at. So I'm going to try and get some more distance between me and him and see if I can maybe be unspotted and take a look at him. And it works. I'm not lit right now, but he's moving too fast. I don't know if he was just aware of the situation and that it wasn't going to work out his favor. Japanese Heavy shows up just in time. Really excited about him showing up. These heavy tanks, the Churchill, the IS-2, if you're not going to be unlit and shooting them dark, which is not going to happen in this situation, it looks like, then you want to go after distracted targets. And this Japanese Heavy could not have come at a better time. Not only is he completely blocking shots from me, notice that I track his target right there. I only see a little bit of the tank, but it's actually a tracking wheel. So now, whatever the Japanese Heavy does to the Churchill, I'm going to get tracking assist for it too. It's a pretty good, concession prize if you're not going to be doing the primary damage. Especially because this gun is such a low alpha. If you can track targets, you need to. Especially so the bigger alpha target teammates can do damage and you get credit for that. Alright. So, I'm not really going to go after the IS-2. I'll let my team deal with that. He's going to get pinched by two heavy tanks. I'm looking for more available, softer targets over here. Here's a tank destroyer. I'm not going to get to him in time. Now, this is not exactly the favorable... after artillery, there's also a T-29 over here, which is not exactly my ideal target. I think I hit the gun.
Nice shot. Right,
alright, now we have a full health T-29. I'm a very healthy E-25, but still, this is not a fight that I really want to take on by myself. Luckily, I have two teammates show up. Again, just like the Churchill, distracted opponents is another strategy to employ here. I alone am not going to go after the T-29, but I'm also not going to be able to turn, you know, to get some distance and get unlit. So this is going to have to be a close encounter. I decide to message them with attack, 3-on-1. There's no way he can shoot all of us. I go first to eat the first shot, but maybe that's enough to promote the idea of teamwork with the rest of my teammates. Take a hard hit there. I'm going to get up into his side right here and just start giving him the DPM business. I could probably take one more shot from him, but my teammates are hitting him so hard and then artillery takes him out. I probably could have taken one more shot from him and I would have... Even if my teammates had been there, I think it would have been a close call just because of the DPM advantage that I have over him. But as you saw, I went by him and then I tried to dig into his side and get close to him. It's such a low profile on this tank that... there's a lot of tanks in this game that cannot get their gun down enough to hit you, and I've run into it on the other end too. Japanese heavies, you can almost seek them out if they're not surrounded by teammates. If you can drive up to them, get to their side, they cannot get their gun down to hit you. You can shoot them into the side completely without any return fire. It's pretty amazing. There's a lot of tanks in the game that are surprisingly unable to get the gun depression to shoot down on an E-25 that's digging into their side. Thanks for watching. Hope you like the videos.